There you see an aerial view of the beautiful Sierra Nevada mountains just outside of Granada. On day four, we'll go to the igloo for the pair's free skate. Around the corner from that, Russia will open its women's hockey competition versus Kazakhstan. Then it's up to the mountains. First, we'll see the women's Super G portion of the combined event. The slalom will go later in the afternoon. And then it's the big air and tricks of women's and men's snowboard halfpipe. Universiad Igloo is the site of figure skating competition here at Universiad in Granada. Good crowd on hand today to see the long program in the pairs competition.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And we'll start off with Vanessa James and Morgan Cyprès of France. They're skating to Angels and Demons, Requiem for a Dream. See the death spiral executed very well. This pair are three-time French champions. And they competed at the 2014 Sochi Winter Olympics, where they placed 10th. They've also competed at three world championships. Well-executed lift sequence here by the pair. Now they set up for one throw, and James just can't quite hold the landing there. She touches down with her hands. Disappointing there for the French duo. James actually competed at the 2010 Vancouver Olympics with then-partner Yannick Bonheur, finishing 14th. And a beautiful lift there to finish things off for Vanessa James and Morgan Cyprès of France. You can see a little bit of disappointment from James. Now to Kristina Astakova and Alexei Roganov of Russia. These two have been partners only since June of 2014. It's a little bit of a step out on that landing. And now for their combination spin. Astakova finished 7th at the 2011 World Junior Championships with then-partner Nikita Bochkov, while Roganov won the 2009 silver medal at the World Juniors. He was then partnered with Anastasia Martavsheva. Then on that throw, the hand comes down for Astakova. This will be a bit of a deduction there. Here's a very well-executed lift by the Russian pair. Now for their combination spin. Very creative. For their final lift. They're skating here to the Master and Margarita by Igor Korneliuk. And a great performance by Astakova and Roganov of Russia. But would it be enough to put them in position for gold? Here is Yu Zhaoyu and Jin Yang of China. They're skating to Humility and Love from the Creation soundtrack. There's a fall for you in that first jump. And their combination spin a little bit out of synchronicity there, but they regain it on the second portion of the spin. These two won gold at the 2012 Winter Youth Olympics and have been partners since 2009. There's a better executed jump for the pair. A bit of a touchdown with the second skate. These two are the 2014 reigning World Junior Champions and won silver back in 2012. You can see the detail in the execution of these lifts. Finish up their performance with this combination spin. And then it will be left up to the judges in terms of who will walk away with gold, silver, and bronze. But a wonderful performance there from Yu and Jin of China. And it will be the Chinese pair that win gold in pairs figure skating at Universiad. You see Roger Roth, the technical chairman for Winter Universiad, presenting the medals. So coming off their World Junior Championship, they now can boast of having gold from the Winter University Games. The silver medals go to Kristina Astakova and Alexei Roganov of Russia, while bronze taken by Vanessa James and Morgan Cypre of France. The Mulathen Pavilion, the site of women's hockey action here at Universiad in Granada. Kazakhstan taking on Russia. Kazakhs lost their opener 7-1 to defending champion Canada. Russia is playing their first game of the tournament. And you see the Russians in their traditional red. Fans on hand to support them, and Kazakhstan in the blue, white, and gold. You see Alexandra Vafina plays her hockey currently in Canada with the University of Calgary, as does Ia Gavrilova. Gavrilova, the team captain here for the Russians. And we are underway in action here, and Kazakhstan with the first chance on goal. Laskina with the save, and then a big traffic jam in front. But it will be Russia that gets the opener. Olga Shashina there with the forehand backhand move to beat Aizen Roshanova. And Russia is up 1-0. Russia again on the forecheck. And the puck will squirt open there to Ekaterina Lebedeva. And she pots home the easy opportunity to the wide open net. Roshanova couldn't slide over quickly enough. And now Russia on the power play. It'll be Ia Gavrilova, the team captain, with the slap shot that eludes the Kazakh goaltender. Got a good view from the opposite end of the ice there. No chance. She couldn't even see that through the traffic. Russia here. Good little give and go. Roshanova can't grab the rebound, and it is tapped home there. That's Alexandra Vafina. And there you see that puck just pop open to her, and she's able to net it home, and Russia now up 4-0. Move now to the second period, and Russia there with the initial stop by Roshanova, but it is cashed in by Shoshina. She made the initial pass to Dergacheva, and then followed up the rebound to put it home. Now Kazakhstan down 5-0. Breakaway goal. That one there from Zarina Tukcheva, and Kazakhstan is on the board. Nice goal by her as she goes 5-hole on Leskina. But Russia comes right back. Puck gets back in front and it deflects there. That's Durgacheva. Deflects off the defenseman's stick up and over the sprawling Roshanova. And quickly, Russia regains their 5-goal lead, which they would carry into the third period. Now in the third, there's Gavrilova, her second of the hockey game. That one squeaks through Roshanova's pads. And again here, you'll get a good look at it. She just turns around and fires it. Roshanova sees it initially, but can't control it. Now Kazakhstan with an opportunity. That puck just pops in front, and there's a great save. Morozova now in goal for Russia, and she stops Felsink. You'll get a good close-up of it here as the puck just pops over to her. Quick little pad save there by Morozova. Russia again on the power play, and a perfect backdoor play there, as that is Shoshina with her hat-trick goal on the great pass from Durgacheva. No chance at all for Roshanova. And then right off the faceoff, Gavrilova steals the puck and she's in all alone, and a backhand over top of Roshanova only 6 seconds after the previous goal by Shoshina, and Gavrilova has her own hat-trick goal. Russia now ahead 9-1. 10 minutes later in the third period, here's a wrister snapped home by Shokina, and Russia moves ahead 10-1. Russia again on the attack, one-on-one, and Vafina uses a screen and puts that one off the post. That's her second of the night. And Russia will close out the scoring here as a nice little pass. Lebedeva sets up Belyakova with the additional assist going to Gavrilova. That's her 6th point of the night, and an easy tap in there for Belyakova. And as the seconds wind down, it will finish 12-1. Russia over Kazakhstan. 3 goals and 3 assists for Iya Gavrilova. 3 goals and 2 assists for Shoshina. And then 2 goals for Alexandra Vafina. Final shots 74-10 in Russia's 12-1 victory. Another beautiful clear day in the Sierra Nevada mountains. So here you see a beautiful shot of Granada. Here now for the Alpine Combined Women's Competition. They'll ski the Super G first in the morning and then the slalom in the afternoon. And the combined times will be put together to determine the medalists. And there you see the athletes warming up, the trainers and equipment staff getting everything ready for the athletes. And the first skier that we will see is Alexandra Prokopieva. She finished 7/100ths out of the bronze medal position in yesterday's Super G race. She has 2 7th place finishes in Super G so far this season in races in Austria and Canada, trying to catch Carmina Palace of Andorra. See, she's carrying really good speed here through the middle part of the course. As she makes her way down through the final gates, is it going to be enough to catch Palace? And it is. A half a second ahead, and she will move currently into first place. Next up is Daria Ovchinnikova of Russia. There's a good look at the course from the top of the hill. She was 7th in Friday's Super G. And at the interval, just a little bit ahead of her Russian counterpart. She competed at a European Cup event 10 days ago at Hinterstoder in Austria, finished 44th there, so she's looking to better that result here at Universiade. Staying quite low through these final turns. There you see the time to beat, and she does beat it. 7/100ths of a second ahead.
1 minute, 2 seconds,
and one Russian replaces another in first place. Now it's Pavla Klichnerova of the Czech Republic. This is her second Universiade. She was fourth in the downhill in 2013 in Trentino and 10th in the Super G. Had a disappointing run in the Super G yesterday, finishing 13th. Half second back at the interval. She makes her way down through the bottom part of the course. And will she be able to sneak past the Russian? No, she doesn't. 3/10ths of a second back for the Czech. Still happy with that result, of course, with the slalom still to come in the afternoon. Now we move to Karolina Kropik of Poland. Had a great day here in Sierra Nevada yesterday, finishing second and taking the silver medal in the Super G. She'll add that medal to the two that she won in Trentino, a silver in the Super G and a bronze in the downhill. 4/100ths back at the interval, needing to make up a little bit of time on the bottom part of the course. Staying nice and low here through those final turns. And there you see the time to beat. And Kropik does just that, moving ahead by almost half a second over the Russian Ovichnikova. And now another Russian, Maria Bitareva, seeing if she can move into first place here in the Super G part of the combined competition. A little bit ahead of Kropik at the interval. Can she maintain that here through the rest of the course? She was fifth in yesterday's Super G, a half second out of the medals. She was also an athlete at her home country Sochi Olympics back a year ago. There is Kropik's time. Can Bedareva maintain her pace? No. She will fall back and move into second place just behind Kropik. A little bit disappointed there, you can see on the face of Bedareva. But again, the slalom still to come. And there you see the results from the Super G portion of the competition. Karolina Kropik in first place. And there are the rest of the top 16 as they prepare now for the slalom. From the Sierra Nevada mountains just outside of Granada, this is the Soulière Snow Park, site of women's and men's half-pipe snowboard competition. Beautiful day up here in the mountains. Temperature of minus 12 degrees Celsius, but relatively clear as you see there. As the athletes get ready, and the good crowd on hand as well to cheer on these athletes. Some final preparations for the course as well. Here you get a more detailed look at the current weather conditions. These athletes have come through qualifying. And there you see the run one from each athlete. And we'll now move into run two. This is Peralt Castellet of Spain. She was the flag bearer for Spain at the opening ceremonies. Has competed in three Olympics, 26th in Torino in 06, was 12th in Vancouver despite not being able to finish her competition due to a concussion, then 11th at the Sochi Games. See the air she's getting here, and a good run there for the Spaniard. but a tough one in her opener, only scoring 37.25. But here she'll score 72.25. That'll move her into second position at the moment. Fifth after the first run, this is Carla Somaini of Switzerland. She's a veteran of the World University Games, having competed in Trentino, finishing fifth in the halfpipe, but she did claim a silver in slopestyle. In round one, she scored 51.75, so she's looking to improve here in run number two. Good grab there, and she's very happy with that second run. Now wait to see what the judges think about it. We'll see one of the grabs that she had on her run down the course. There's the second one. Sporting the blue hair today, she will score 67.75, and that'll move her into third spot. And now it is Kai Jui Tong, arguably the favorite in this competition. She finished sixth at the Olympics in Sochi last February, and recently won gold at the Snowboard World Championships with a score of 94.25. That was the best score of the competition, either men or women. A native of Harbin, China. And you can just see the incredible air that she gets here as compared to the other competitors. And she will finish. Her opening run was 82.50. We'll see if her second run is better than that. We get a good close-up glimpse of the air that she gets. She's pretty happy. And the judges will give her a 75.25, so her first run of 82.50 will hold up as the best of the competition, and Kai will win gold for China. Castellate takes silver for Spain, and Somaini from Switzerland claims bronze. Now to the men's competition. One of the favorites in this one, Zhang Yiwei of China, first after qualifying. He finished sixth at the Olympics in Sochi, but struggled in his opening run and sat 12th. Third after the first run, it's Zachary Black of the United States. And you see the huge air that he gets on that one. And the ability to not only manage the air, but of course perform the tricks is what really elevates these incredible athletes. You see Black nearing the end of the pipe. And he will wrap things up on his run, pretty happy with that one. You see that initial hand plant. And his final air. Scored 85 in his first run, 90.50 in his second, so that will stand up for him. Now to Brock Waring, also of the United States. Based out of Colorado in the US. He was third after the first run. He's also third after qualifying with a score of 86.25. Massive air there. And that'll wrap up his second run. We'll get a great view here from the camera that trails behind the riders. And a good close-up there of the huge air that Waring got. And his first run will hold up 85.50. And now it's Ayumu Nedofuji, the Japanese rider, second after qualifying with 89.25. He was at the Sochi Olympics last year in Russia, finished 32nd, though two of his countrymen, Ayumu Hirano and Taku Haraoka, took silver and bronze respectively, so a good snowboarding culture in Japan. And huge air on his final trick, and that will be it for Nedofuji. And the only question now is, where are they all going to fit on the podium? Huge air there for the Japanese rider.
snowboard world captain. He got the second position.
Now you get a close-up view right into our camera location of the air that Netta Fuji got. He scores only a 28 here on run two, but his 91.50 from his initial run will hold up. He will claim gold. Second place goes to Zachary Black of the United States, and third, also to the Americans, it's Brock Waring.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.